She's like, when the weather gets good, I'm just going to set $600 on fire.
Yeah.
She's in Michael Wood territory now. She's like, I'm just going to set it on fire.
Yeah.
Go, girl.
I can't wait, you guys. This business has been so awesome for me. I did, and I'm totally going to brag on this because I don't get to tell people about my crab vacation anymore, but we went to Maryland, not this past year, but in 2019. And there's 13 of us. And you guys, I caught enough blue crabs out of the Chesapeake Bay to feed all 13 of us. And I cleaned those bitches by myself and I cooked them by myself. And I have to tell you, I don't think I would have done that if it wasn't for this business. There's so many things that I would not have done that I've done because of this business. Because like, you know that you're capable of doing things, you know, like obviously like
she's been doing some amazing stuff. You're talking about somebody that's got, what is it? Determination and grit. That's somebody I can't wait to meet. And when I go up to Ohio, I'm going to not tell Keith G, skip him, because who wants to see him? And then tell Mary and have Mary meet me with Kait, and we'll go out to eat or something. Hopefully, right, COVID, be less. Mark, are you,
Mark? Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah. What you got for us, with Kait, and let's get that on the road in case Kait has to, do crap.
Well, one thing I've been noticing on the old social medias is, of course she has jumped on the fridge meals, and I've been looking at the pictures and watching what she's posting, and it sounds very interesting. So I thought that it might be a good idea, since she's got an operation the size of most everybody's operation, for us to hear from her how she's doing it, how she, you know, things like how do you choose your menu and how do you prep the food and how do you get it to them? How, you know, all of that, just to hear how they're doing it on a smaller scale. And maybe that would inspire somebody else to go do the old fridge meals. Well, because, I mean, when you look at some other, you know, when you see somebody else doing it on a giant scale, you're like, I can't do that. I don't have the people. I don't have the time. I don't have the money. But for somebody that has gone the trouble to take all of that 30,000 foot overview and bring it down and put it on a, instead of flying a gigantic 737, now you're flying a little Cub Piper. Then everybody can say, oh yeah, you know, I can do that.
I've always admired Kait just because she's gone through ups and downs. So when y'all hear her talk, don't go, well, that's just, she just got lucky. No, Kait didn't get lucky about 900 times. She didn't get lucky. And she has stuck with it. I'm talking a badass. And so she just impresses me. And I love the way she puts her stuff out. Like when she takes photos, they're good. When she dresses up her cart, when she does her, she was in a greenhouse factory kind of deal. And I interviewed her, but she did a video for us all. And you can go back and look at that on the Facebook group. But how she laid out everything and made it look good, it's why men and women are less cautious to go up to somebody that's got a setup like that, because they know they took the effort to that. They know they're going to be clean as well.
Man, so, you know, the other thing that really super impresses me, she came back from the brink. I mean, was literally, she can tell us herself, but I got the idea that she was just days away from saying, I'm just done, because she was seriously snowed under in a figurative sense. And the most amazing thing is she took some concepts and simply applied them. She wasn't one of those people that had some issues, asked for some advice, and then said, oh yeah, you know, I don't want to do that. I want to do something entirely different, and I think it'll work. But she came back from the brink, and you know, I'm just super impressed with that kind of moxie. There's a good word for you tonight.
That's a good one. Yeah, I like moxie. It probably won't offend people like my badass word. So I want to say this though, too. I want to bring up something else that just, it warmed my heart when Kait told me she was taking her entire family, paying for it, and taking them to the coast so that they could experience the beach and go crabbing and go fishing and enjoy a home on the beach. And she was able to do that because of hot dogs, and because not just hot dogs, because of what she brought to hot dogs, what she was able to do, make herself go do. And you're talking to somebody, it's a single mom. This isn't like, oh, she doesn't have anything else to do. She's independently free any other time. No, she has a whole life, all the hectic that goes with all of our lives. She has that and a little more. She doesn't have, there's not somebody there to help. And so she just takes the reins and it's, I don't know, it inspires me. It's kind of like when Brian Williams posts up stuff, you know, some people get bored with that. I don't get bored with that. Jason used to post up, you know, we did 9,000 today before lunch, had to close up early. And I go, I like hearing that because it inspires me. It doesn't make me feel like, oh crap, well, he's just tooting his own horn. No, that's meant to inspire. So, Mark, can you go ahead and you came up with great questions. Go ahead and rattle those off to Kait for us.
Girl, you in here?
Yep.
Bring it on. Spotlighter, man. Nobody needs to look at me. I'm old and ugly.
Boom.
Hey,
Kait. Girl. Good to see you.
With such an introduction, you guys, I hope I don't let you down, because I'll tell you, I'm not very Brian Williams about my fridge meals. I don't think I put as much into it as he does.
Well, the thing is, though, is you put what's necessary, period, and you bring something different to the table. So we've had Brian on, and Brian's brilliant. He's brought a lot to the group. He's an asset.
Really is. I've taken a lot from him, for sure.
But this is even better because of the information he shared. You've taken that and put it in your own method and come up with your own system. And that's what I want to hear, because some people may look at Brian's and be overwhelmed, like Mark was saying, you know, bring it down to the Piper Cub plane instead of the 737. And let's see what's going on with yours. I can't wait to find out. Mark will lead you, and then you can take it where you want.
All right, so here's the deal. How long have you been doing the refrigerator meals?
Since the week before Christmas.
And on a scale from 1 to 10, how do you think it's going?
I would say a 12. I have to, right now I am at the point where I need to find a bigger commercial space and either hire somebody to start doing them for me before, I would say, the end of March, or I'll have to do, like, I think, like, Steve Anderson, maybe, who is only doing them through the wintertime and stopping in the summertime, because I will not have the time to dedicate to fridge meals. And while they're doing awesome, I'm a one-person operation for the most part, so I won't be able to do both of them, and I like doing my cart way more than fridge meals. So it's not even a consideration.
Right. But you've been successful at it. So the first thing is, how do you choose your doggone menu?
So mostly I just try to make it casserole dishes or things that you can easily make on a bulk scale. So I started with, like, the simplest like crock pot dishes that you could just multiply easily, and then few ingredients, nothing fancy. Most people aren't looking for anything fancy. They're excited about having an affordable meal option that offers delivery, because, like, HelloFresh and stuff like that is ridiculously expensive for
hella expensive people.
Yeah.
All right, so that leads us to the next thing is, so how many, well, I guess before I ask the next question, item next, how many different fridge meals have you got right now in rotation?
So I've been doing 4 different fridge meals a week, and I haven't repeated any. So I don't know, however long
that's been. That's pretty stout. If you haven't repeated any yet.
Yeah.
So are you just getting this off Pinterest, or are you just coming out of your awesome, beautiful mind? What's the deal?
So how I started was with meals that, like, I like to eat. And then I, from there, I kind of am just like, I track. So, like, the basis of my menu, how I plan it, is obviously you want to have different proteins, because not everybody eats pork, not everybody eats chicken, etc. So I'll usually try to have one protein overlap into two meals, and then have, so, like, this week I have 2 ground beef meals, 1 chicken, and then 1 with shrimp and crab. So that's, like, the main thing. And then past that, I honestly look at the ingredients that I have left over from the previous week, any ingredients that I have left over, and I try to incorporate those into it. So there was, like, a lot of carrots and potatoes meals last week. Like, I made, like, an apple chicken stew that had carrots and potatoes in it. And then I also made a pork pozole that had carrots in it and stuff like that. So I try to make meals that have ingredients that are overlapping so that I'm not buying 10 different ingredients for every single meal.
Right.
And then if there's a bunch left over of something, because, you know, some stuff you can't buy in the smaller quantities that I would need, because obviously I'm a one person operation. So I don't need like a mass quantity of all of them because I cut my ordering off whenever it gets to max capacity. And then, yeah. So if I have a bunch of ingredients left over, then I'll just get online and like kind of look up like what, like the best casserole dishes of 2020 or something like that, or best comfort foods and stuff, and see where I can incorporate those ingredients into the following week to kind of use up everything and keep it moving. Like, it's just not, I'm not to where I actually need to like consider it and stuff like that. I never
would. Isn't that a good feeling though? Isn't that a great feeling to know that you know you're financially secure enough, or you have plans for your cart, and that's what you enjoy doing, that this doesn't have to be a thing. Which gives you a lot more freedom.
Yeah. I love my cart, and I love feeding people. So, I mean, I don't care what I do. I just like to feed people. But I definitely enjoy doing my cart more than my friend.
Dennis says, Caitlin, are these all pre-orders, or do you make a certain number each week? You offer a certain number.
Pre-orders. So I post up the menu on Wednesdays, and they can order from Wednesday at whenever I get it up to Sunday at 2 p.m. unless I reach max capacity, and then I just shut it off.
Okay.
Right on.
And then I deliver. So then Sunday I do the cutoff at 2 p.m. because with my distribution guy, I have to have my order into him by 3 p.m. on Sunday for delivery on Monday. And then I can get my delivery on Monday so that I can just cook my ass off all day on Tuesday. You guys, it's still great. I don't leave the kitchen.
Our next question, your next question is from Lewis. He wants to know, what is your max capacity? Like, do you have a cutoff if you get 50 orders?
Yeah. 50 orders is my max capacity.
Oh, I guess just guessed and was randomly correct.
That's so 50 orders. If you're like thinking about like 50 hot dogs or something like that, that's not shit. 50 fridge meals is a lot for one person to pump out. Like, I am literally on Tuesdays, if I hit 50 orders on Tuesdays, I will start at like, as soon as I drop my kid off at school, I'll head to the kitchen and I will leave the kitchen and go pick her up from school and then go back to the kitchen. So when you ask, like, on a scale of 1 to 10, how good is it doing? I have not spent any money at all on marketing. I haven't boosted a post. I haven't shared them to my local community pages. I've literally posted it up on my business page and that's it. I am nervous to boost a post, to pay for an ad, or to share it to my community pages, because I am like, if I walk away from my phone after doing that, I don't want to come back to a ridiculous amount of orders. Like,
right. You're doing what you want to do there. So, right. Yeah, and you, a lot of times that is exactly what will happen. You'll get yourself into a hole that you've got to call for big help to get out of. Hey guys,
you guys, I just stood outside yesterday for what's today. Today is Monday. Yeah. So yesterday I stood outside and it was like 10 degrees with the wind chill. And I even stayed out longer than normal. I was out till 4, which I wasn't happy about, but, I was out there for 4 hours, 5, if you include setup and tear down. And, you guys, I wouldn't trade it for anything. I'll stand out there in the freezing rain. I don't care. I love it. I love feeding people. I love the smiles that I get to see. People know when they come to my cart that they're just gonna have a good conversation. You know, like I have a customer service background and stuff. So, you know, you always get my customer service voice and everything. And they just know they're coming for a good lunch, a good time. They're not going to McDonald's. They're not going to get a shitty order with bad food after they pay $10 for it or whatever. But I totally dig it. I love it. I can't even see myself doing anything else. Like, I really wasn't even planning on doing these fridge meals, like I said, just because I'm just like, I don't know. I just don't find the joy in just like
cooking in the kitchen.
Being out there and talking to everybody. I would definitely rather go out there and talk to everybody. But I got so damn bored, you guys. We are in an Arctic freeze right now. I am in the southernmost part of Northeast Ohio, and it has been snowing and so freaking cold, and I have really bad asthma, so it makes it difficult to breathe if it's too cold out there. But bless these ladies' hearts. I have like super awesome places that I set up. They all love me. They let me come inside whenever I want tar for Christmas. But it was just the cutest thing. I can't wait. She goes out there with me now. She's like, hot dogs, get your hot dogs. And like, if people walk past the cart and don't get a hot dog, she's like, oh, you don't like hot dogs?
Yeah, I'm just going to say, for anybody listening to this, watching it live, or if you're on playback, my question for you is, what the hell is wrong with you? Don't have excuses. Don't, only if I could just whatever it is. This girl right here is a great example of what I call warrior mode engaged. She just is doing it, and just doing it. And that's just a girl. You are an inspiration.
Thank Absolutely.
You're getting me excited. I'm not supposed to go out and vend tomorrow, but I might, just because you just got me all fired up. Tomorrow's supposed to be my day off.
Bad. I've been off for 2 weeks now, and yesterday it was supposed to be like the beginning of the week said it was going to be like 30 degrees, and this little boutique shop that I set up in front of, check out a boutique, you guys. You think that they're like not going to have anything, but this lady is busy all day. And I've been setting up there since October, and yesterday in the 10 degree weather, I had my record day in front of that store.
And I can do this. And the fact that you're doing it, and over and over and over, and even, you know, Michael, while we've been on here, Michael messaged me and said, you remember when her cart fell apart, completely fell apart, and she rebuilt it from scratch? Do you remember when her car broke down? And I'm going, yep. And it's true, because that's what it takes. And most of us have that in us. We're entrepreneurs, and we'll fight the battles. We'll run into an obstacle, and we overcome that obstacle. That obstacle now becomes just something we need to get around, over through. For some, it's a barrier. Some of it, you know, for some, those obstacles we see are barriers. They're just done with it. Okay, well, I'm going to have to go back. But here's somebody that managed, a district manager or something, of $85 bajillion generals, and was already overworked. So she wasn't scared of work. That was obvious. So getting into this, she got more time with her kids, got to take this awesome family vacation, and now gets to say, hey, you know, if it doesn't work out with this fridge meal thing, it's great for the winter, but I'm gonna, you know,
I can't wait to get back to the car. I'm so tired of fridge meals. I know I'm going to have a really big disappointed clientele though, because like, there are people that have not missed an order, or people that will like message me and be like, I missed the deadline, I forgot to order it. I'm like,
I mean, obviously a lot of work, a lot of effort, but she was putting in that effort and work for someone else to make money. And then being salaried, they tell you how many hours you're going to work. You don't quit at 40. Right. You don't quit at 80. And no. I mean, you told me before, you worked over 80 hours a lot of times.
I would drop my kid off at like 4:30 in the morning to drive an hour or more to go fix somebody else's store and not get back to her till 10, 10:30, 11 o'clock at night sometimes.
Yeah, I was out there. And I'll tell you, it was Saturday. I was out there, and I'll tell you what, guys, had a fantastic time. It was a little cold, a little chilly, but I served the hot chocolate, served the coffee and the mini donuts. Of course, I had the rest of the meals that I normally do, and they did fantastic. But those mini donuts, I mean, I sold almost about 3/4 of a case of mini donuts. They were having their Valentine dance with these older folks, and they really loved it. So I just wanted to give you an update on those mini donuts, and they're kicking butt down here in South Texas.
Now you're going to be doing breakfast too, right? Aren't you doing some days there for breakfast?
Yes, I've got, well, because of the mini donuts, I was supposed to get this done tomorrow as far as taking the mini donuts with the coffee and hot chocolate and stuff. And I was going to do some breakfast items, but unfortunately down here in South Texas, this cold weather is very, very rare. The last time we've had it was back in 89. That lowest, it was a little bit lower than 23 degrees as it was today, this morning. Everything was frozen over, which is very rare down here where I live. And the events that I've had today, all canceled out, tomorrow canceled out. So I should be out there and doing something on Wednesdays, but I should be back next Tuesday to this park that picked me up for the mini donuts, coffees, and breakfast.
Cool.
So I'm pretty excited about that.
What other breakfast items are you going to do for that?
For now, I think I'm going to keep it simple. You know, I got some eggs, bacon and eggs, potato and eggs, things like that, and make them into a taco. Everybody down here loves tacos, so making a flour tortilla. And
last year at a rodeo, and I had tons of people in line wanting their hair in their horse's hair braided. Charging them $25. I charged one lady. I said, for you, $25. She goes, that's it? And I go, yeah. I was getting excited. I don't know how much to charge people on food or anything, and I just charge them, and they get excited about it. Thanks to you guys. You guys are awesome charging. I said, oh my gosh, how in the world am I going to charge this kind of my own money? And I do it, and they go, okay. And I was, thanks to you guys.
Well, but anyways,
yes, sir. Thank you.
I thank you for sharing. I want to wish everybody a great week, and I love you. I want you
love
to
you
go out there and change your day. Be like Tortilla and Kait and anybody else. If that doesn't inspire you, get in the group and go, hey, I need some inspiration today. Nothing wrong with that.